Today we're going to learn how to make stuff appear and disappear inside our website using jQuery. And as you guys can see in front of me here, I have a very basic website with a navigation. And what we want to do in this episode is make this navigation appear and disappear when we click this navigation button up in the top left corner. Now, of course, in my example here, I want to make a navigation appear and disappear, but it's important that you guys know that we can make anything inside our website appear and disappear using the jQuery code from this lesson here. If you guys want to have a navigation, you guys can do this together with me. You can go ahead and download the lesson files in the description of this video. So in order to make this navigation appear and disappear, we're going to use two different methods. We're going to use something called hide and show, and we're going to use something called fade. So the first one is simply where we make this appear and disappear in some kind of speed, if you want to, or we can just make it instant. And the second way is we can make this fade out by changing the opacity or fade in again. So as you guys can see inside my document here, the only code we have in here that is not jQuery right now is a link to a style sheet. And then at the bottom here, we have a header that has an image inside of it, which is the one at the top here with the logo or the menu button. And the second thing we have in here is the navigation. So inside the navigation tags, we have two unordered lists with two different menus inside of it. And what we're going to do today is when we click this image up here, then we want to do something with jQuery, which in this case is going to make the navigation tags appear and disappear. So if we were to go down to the script tags I have at the very bottom of my document here, you guys can see I have no jQuery code inside the script tags. Now the first thing we're going to do is make sure that the jQuery code does not load as the first thing inside the website. Now right now, since we have the script tags at the bottom, this is not going to be an issue because the document is loaded from top to bottom. But if we were to put this at the top of the document, we would have to write something called $ parentheses, and then say we have a document dot ready parentheses semicolon, because we always need to end off a line of jQuery code with a semicolon. And inside the parentheses, we want to write function parentheses curly brackets, and then whatever code goes inside the curly brackets is going to be loaded last inside the document. So if I were to have the script tags, if I were to just copy them and put them up here in the head tag instead, now this code would actually not be loaded first because we inserted a function inside jQuery that says you need to load this after loading the rest of the page. So even though this is at the first of the documents, it's not going to get loaded first. Now, just because it's a habit that I have, I'm going to go ahead and put the script tags at the bottom of the document, just like we do in JavaScript. So down here, I'm just going to go ahead and keep this for now because it doesn't hurt to have it, to make sure that the code actually gets loaded last. So inside the jQuery code, which gets loaded after everything else inside the website, I'm going to go ahead and include a selector. Now remember, the selector is the thing that determines what needs to happen something to in order for something else to happen inside the website. So in this case, I want to do something when I click the button up here, or the image, which right now is the button. So we need to select the image in here using jQuery. So if I were to go down inside my code, I'm going to go ahead and open up a selector by writing $ parentheses double quotes, and inside the double quotes, I want to select the image. Now, right now, because we have no other images inside the website, I could simply say we have a image, but because I want to make sure we don't accidentally choose another type of image at some point later on this website, I'm going to go ahead and give this image a ID. So we're going to say we have an ID equal to double quotes, and then we're going to say menu-toggle, just so it has some kind of name. I'm going to go ahead and copy this name, go down to my jQuery code, and then I'm going to say we have a ID called menu-toggle. So now we selected the image up here, and we can go ahead and tell it what needs to happen to it before we run some kind of code. So in this case, the event is going to be a click event. So when we click on the image, something needs to happen. So we're going to go ahead and say parentheses, semicolon, because we're ending off this line of code. And inside the parentheses, I'm going to go ahead and write a function, because I want to run this function as soon as I click the button. Now inside the function, we're going to add a second selector. So we're going to say we have a $ parentheses, and then I want to select the navigation, because it's the navigation, something needs to happen to when we click this button up here. So I'm going to go ahead and go up to my navigation and see, well, right now we have a navigation called nav, but just to make sure we don't close every single navigation inside my website, I'm going to go ahead and give this navigation an ID. So we're going to say ID equal to double quotes, and I'm going to go ahead and call this one side dash nav. Then I'm going to copy the ID name and paste it inside our jQuery code. Of course, we need to remember to add the ID tag in front of it. Afterwards, we need to add a effects, which is what we call it when we want to do something to the element we chose. And in this case, we're going to use an effect called hide. So I'm going to say hide, parentheses, and semicolon. So right now we're using the default hide function or the default hide effect inside jQuery. So if we were to go inside my website, refresh, then click the button up here, you guys can see the navigation disappears. So it's very similar to the feature we have inside YouTube where we can actually close the navigation, and then if we click it, it should actually open up again. Right now it doesn't do it. So if I were to go back inside my code, I can go ahead and use another effect called show, like so. And if I were to go inside my style sheet and say that the navigation needs to be hidden all the time when we do actually refresh the browser, by going down inside my nav styling and then say display none. So right now, if I were to refresh the browser, you guys can see we have no navigation inside my website. Now, if I click the button, you guys can see it appears. Now, of course, we don't want to be able to just make it disappear or appear. So we have another feature called toggle inside jQuery. So I'm going to go ahead and say instead of show, I'm going to say toggle, which right now switches in between show and hide when I click the button. So if we were to go back inside the website, refresh, you guys can see it's hidden right now. If we were to click the navigation button, it appears. If we were to click it again, it disappears. So this is a really nice effect to have inside jQuery. Now, when it comes to these effects, inside the parentheses, we can go ahead and insert some parameters. Now, when it comes to hide, show, and toggle, we have two different parameters. The first parameter is going to be the speed at which the effect is going to happen, and the second one is going to be something we call a callback. So the first one, we can go ahead and say we want this to happen over a period of 1 second, which is 1,000 milliseconds. If we were to then refresh the browser, you guys can see the navigation appears from the side of the screen. If we were to click it again, it disappears slowly during a period of 1 second. Now, if we were to go back inside my code and say, well, we also want to add a callback, I'm going to say comma, space, and then I'm going to go ahead and include another function, parentheses, curly brackets, and tell it that it should also alert a message inside the browser. So I'm going to go ahead and say alert, double quotes, hi there. So right now, basically what we're telling it is that we're going to go ahead and run this toggle feature. After 1 second, it needs to be done. And then afterwards, after the effect is actually done, then we want a callback, which means that we can do something once the effect is done loading, which right now alerts a message called hi there. So we're to save this, go inside my browser, refresh. Now you guys will notice that when the navigation appears or disappears, we're going to go ahead and get a message called hi there. So I click it, and then we get the message. If I were to do it again, it's done loading, and then we get the message. So a callback is basically when it does something after it's done loading the effect. Again, right now I just used a alert message in order to write something to me, but we could actually do much more stuff than just an alert message. You know, we can actually run other types of effects after this one is done. So we can actually chain events inside the callback. So this is how we can use toggle, show, and hide. But what if we want something to fade in and fade out, so we actually get a opacity change inside the browser? Now let's actually go and delete some of the stuff that we have here. If we were to delete everything back to right after the punctuation mark, so we need to add the effect, I'm going to go ahead and use an effect called fade in. And do pay attention to the capitalized I here, because we need to make sure when we have two words inside an effect name, the first letter is going to be not capitalized, and then the second word is going to be capitalized. It's a typical habit to do that inside jQuery or JavaScript or PHP, just because it makes it easier to see the different words inside the name of the effect or the functions. So we're going to go and make sure we don't forget to include the capitalized letters. Then we're going to say parentheses. Now inside these effects here, we can also add a speed and a callback feature inside the parameters. For now, we're just not going to do it. So I'm just going to go ahead and save it, go inside my browser, refresh. And now you guys will notice that when I click, it fades in. So we have an opacity change from 0 to 1 after a certain time. If I were to go back inside the code, we can also go ahead and say fade out, like so. I'm going to go ahead and go back inside my styling and remove the styling called display none, because we need to actually see the navigation when we refresh the browser, like so. If we were to click the button, you guys can see it fades out. Now we also have something called fade toggle inside jQuery. So if we want to say fade toggle, just like before, it's going to go ahead and switch between fade out and fade in when we click the button. So I'm going to go ahead and go into my website, refresh, and you guys can see when I click the button, it fades out. When I click it again, it fades in. Now, of course, we can also add the parameters inside the effect in here. So we can actually say 1000 milliseconds. Just going to save it, refresh the browser. And as you guys can see, now it fades out much slower than before. Now, when it comes to the fade effects inside jQuery, we have one more fade effect we can use, which is something that allows for us to decide when the opacity needs to stop. So right now we have the fade toggle. If we were to say fade to, we can actually decide inside the parameters where the opacity needs to stop changing to. So if we were to say right now we want to fade to some kind of opacity after a certain time, I can say 1000, which is 1 second, comma, then I'm going to add the second parameter, which is going to be some kind of opacity like the one we have in CSS. So I'm just going to say 0.5 just to have something. Save it. If I go inside my browser, refresh, you guys can see when I click it, it's going to fade out halfway. So now we can actually still see the navigation, but it's halfway transparent, just like we decided to inside the jQuery. Now, if we were to go back inside the code, I want to let you guys know that we still have the callback parameter in here, so we don't have two parameters. In this case, we have three different parameters. So we could still say we want to add a function, parentheses, curly brackets for the third parameter, and do a callback called alert, because why not? And inside the alert, we can also say hi there. So now if I go back inside the browser, refresh, it's going to take 1 second to fade out halfway, and then afterwards it's going to alert a message called hi there. So I'm going to click it, 1 second, and we get the message. So these are some of the different effects we can use in order to make stuff appear and disappear inside jQuery. And like I said, it's actually very simple to do. We just need to add a selector that selects something inside the website that we want to interact with a event. And then afterwards, we need to tell it with a selector what we want to change and then what needs to happen to it using an effect. So hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys next time.